I think we're live. I'm not sure. I'm hoping we are. It says, whoops, I'm seeing if anything's coming. Oh, we're live, I think.
Yeah, you're live.
We're live. We got lost there for a second. I was publishing it on the Kevin Evans Facebook, which is attached to the Evans and Doherty Facebook. And in other words, I'm telling you, I hadn't a clue what I was doing. And luckily, my lovely wife was able to call our good friend Carla Pilgrim, who besides being one of the best singers in the entire world, knows what she's doing on Facebook. So, cheers. This is not Coca-Cola, but yes it is. My lovely wife is here with us today, trying to get me through this whole thing. I've had tons of requests from all of you. I'm just going to go with this until we stop, and just getting me picks together here, and I'm hoping that you're having a good day out there. It is Valentine's Day, and I'm going to sing a couple of Valentine's Day songs in this set. Both we had a request for, which is kind of nice. So all the songs today are requests. There's one or two that were specially requested that I actually haven't done before, so this should be fun. My wife loves this song, I love this song, Darcy Broderick loves this song, Stephanie Clark loves this song, so I'll start off with this one. It's called Across the Great Divide. It's a great Kate Wolf tune. Joni's over there watching on another screen. I'm sitting right next to her. Like, how do I look on TV, huh?
You look beautiful.
Well, I've been walking in my sleep, counting troubles instead of counting sheep. Where the years went, I can say I just turned around and they've gone away. Well, I've been sifting through the layers of dusty books and faded papers. They tell a story that I used to know. It was one that happened long ago. It's gone away in yesterday, and I find myself on the mountainside, where the rivers change direction across the great divide. Well, I heard the owl calling softly as the night was falling, with a question, and I replied, but he's gone across the borderline. He's gone away yesterday, and I find myself on the mountainside, where the rivers change direction across the great divide. Now the finest hour that I have seen is the one that comes between the edge of night and the break of day, when the darkness goes away. It's gone away in yesterday, and I find myself on the mountainside, where the rivers change direction across the great divide. It's gone away in yesterday, I find myself on the mountainside, where the rivers change direction, cross the great divide. Where the rivers change direction, across the great divide. Hi, Lennon and Beckett, and I'm hoping Charlie and Meek are watching too. Those are my grandkids, and maybe in Ireland as well. I have no idea.
Well,
you never know.
Nigel is on from Ireland.
Nigel Doherty. Brian Doherty's brother is on from Oma in the north of Ireland. And now there's a man. Myself and Nigel, one day Brian went playing golf, and myself and Nigel went on a tear around Waterford. We went into the world's, certainly Ireland's smallest pub. It was an excellent story because we walked in this little hallway and then it opened into a fairly large room, and Nigel turned to me and said, there's nothing small about this pub. This is just a normal pub. I said, no, the hallway is a pub. It's registered separately as a pub. You can fit like three people in there or something. And we went to Mickey Kent's, who originally was closed. And I'll tell you a story about Mickey Kent's some other time because it's not short. Yes.
Chris is on from out west. Your niece Chris.
Oh,
is
my
here.
Niece. Oh,
Paul this. Bump is here. Sharon Daly from Ireland is here. Let's see.
Sounds like there's loads of you.
Judy Guptill is here. Lots
wow. Okay. Well, I'm being informed as to who's visiting. It's lovely to see you all. I know you can see us, and welcome to our home, our sitting room. We were going to light the fire, but it's still broad daylight out here, and we have sun today. No snow, no ice, no dark skies. Beautiful sun today, so can't really see the flames. And we didn't turn. I like the fact that my head is kind of right in the middle of the screen back there, but it is what it is. Very informal today. I've all the requests that I've gotten so far, and there's loads and loads and loads of requests, got more today. I'm making a pact with you all that I'm going to do every single one of them. There's enough already for at least 4 episodes of our Corum Tunes 2021 concerts. So I'm just going to blast on with a bunch of them today. There's a high possibility you won't hear your song this week, but you'll hear your song next week or the week after, and I'll be delighted to do it. We just picked them as they're just, as I said, it's Valentine's Day, so there are a couple of love songs in there. And This is one that I've been doing for years and years. Myself and Brian Doherty, as Evans Doherty, did it. I did it many years before that. I've been doing it since, it's a tune called Streets of London, and written by Ralph McTell, a great English songwriter. And Ralph, very, very recently, and I'll do it today, wrote a brand new verse to this. So if I stumble and fall, I'll pick myself up and finish the verse, I promise. Anyway, Streets of London. Have you seen the old man in the closed-down market, kicking up the papers with his worn-out shoes? In his eyes you'll see no pride, held loosely by his side, yesterday's papers telling yesterday's news. And how can you tell me you're lonely? Save for you, the sun don't shine. Let me take you by the hand, I'll lead you through the streets of London. I'll show you something to make you change your mind. Have you seen the old girl as she walks the streets of London? Dirt in her hair and her clothes in rags. She's got no time for talking. She just keeps right on walking. carrying her world into carrier bags. And how can you tell me you're lonely? And say for you, the sun don't shine. Let me take you by the hand. I'll lead you through the streets of London. I'll show you something to make you change your mind. In the All Night Cafe at 11:15, same old man sitting there on his own. He's looking at the world over the rim of his teacup. Each tea lasts an hour, and he wanders home alone. So how can you tell me you're lonely? And say for you the sun don't shine. Let me take you by the hand. I'll lead you through the streets of London. I'll show you something to make you change. Have you seen the old man outside the seaman's mission? His memory's fading dim like the ribbons that he wears. In this wintry city, the rain cries little pity for one more forgotten hero and a world that doesn't care. And how can you tell me you're lonely? Say for you the sun don't shine. Let me take you by the hand. I'll lead you through the streets of London. I'll show you something to make you change your mind. In shop doorways, under bridges, all our towns and cities, you can glimpse the makeshift bedding from the corner of your eye. Remember what you're seeing barely hides a human being. We're all in this together, brother, sister, you and I. And how can you tell me you're lonely? Say for you, the sun don't shine. Let me take you by the hand. I'll lead you through the streets of London. I'll show you something to make you change your mind. And how can you tell me you're lonely? And say for you, the sun don't shine. Let me take you by the hand. I'll lead you through the streets of London. I'll show you something to make you change your mind. I'll show you something to make you change your mind. I love it. Audience of one, inside the bubble, as they say. My heavens. That's a beautiful song. I first learned that song from the singing of my best friend in Ireland. God rest him, gone now. Paddy Daly taught me that song many, many years ago. When I only knew three chords, and I didn't know them well, Paddy taught me the minors, which was a big deal. Now, you probably noticed where this glass was when I first started. So this is an amazing glass. This fills itself. I'm telling you. Okay, another request. Now I'm especially going to do this request today. It has been requested by a few people, but this is especially for my good friend Pat Chisloud in BC. We've met Pat a few times over the years. Pat usually, I don't know, he must have some sort of a radar for a good night. Because every time we've met Pat, it has turned into a good night, a long night, and good night. Pat actually personally showered me with way too many Jack Daniels one night that we weren't quite stranded so much as we kind of got to, we were out in Calgary actually when Pat showed up, and that was kind of the end of that evening in a very good way. Pat's a great performer in his own right. Check him out. Pat Chisel. Pat asked for this last year, and I'm getting to it now. This is a song called I Saw Her in the Music Shop. This is dedicated to guitars. There's a D45 mentioned. There's a D28 mentioned. This is a D28, kind of dutied up, but it's a D28. And it's about guitars. For you, Pat. I saw her in a music shop, not far away, just round the block from where I lived. And there she stood, shone majestically, a brand new Martin 45, all the bells and whistles. Man alive, I knew I had to have it just for me. I opened the door, I wandered in, I could not conceal my silly grin. The salesman, haven't seen that look, he nodded knowingly. He sat me down upon a chair, then from the window, with great care, he gently placed the beauty on my knee. She was amazing, she was beautiful, and the songs she sang were new. And though it seemed to break my heart, from her to part, I did the only thing that I could do. I wandered home to you. Cause roughly 20 years ago, to a music shop I chanced to go. In the corner sat a wonder, she was beckoning to me. A weathered Martin 28, to own her, I could hardly wait, cause I knew I had to have her just for me. She was older, but she was so beautiful, and the songs she sang were true. And when I knew that it would break my heart, from her to part, I did the only thing I wandered home with you. And though changes they have come and gone, you still know the words to each and every song. You were a treasure to discover, there could never be another like you. And though you are old, you are so very beautiful, and the songs you sing are true. Though it seems like I might break your heart, from you I'll never part. I do the only thing that I can do. I stay right here. I'll raise a glass to toast your wood. The man who made you good. And I knew I had to have you just for me. For Pat.
Beautiful.
Oh, there's Joni still at it now. Oh, okay, let's see about this one now. We're getting all kinds of requests still. I just put songs together, so if something jumps up, I'll be informed, no doubt. Any more requests coming through?
There have been a few requests, but a couple of them, unfortunately, you don't really normally do as part of your repertoire, but you will have to learn them.
Like what?
Lovely Marianne.
Lovely Marianne. Oh, there's a song. Okay, I'll do that one. Not today.
Yeah, So the ones that you don't normally do, you'll have to learn.
Yes, well, you keep track of them now. Now, do we have a, will we have a record of those so we can kind of write them in?
Yeah.
Oh, lovely. Okay. Lovely Marianne. I tell you now, it would be pretty hard to beat Richard Harrington's version of that song. So what I will do, when I do sing that song, I'll sing it in honor of Richard. Anyway, this is a tune called Rolling in the Clover. Now, we did this as Evans and Doherty. Let's see. And I don't know if we actually ever, did we ever do this live, Joni?
I don't know.
I don't know that we ever did.
Once or twice.
But we did get a pile of requests for it. Now, Joni's sister, my sister-in-law, is Dawn Trainor Thompson, an incredibly talented songwriter, great singer. We do concerts together all the time. She wrote this song. She also wrote Madeline, which I will be probably doing next week. I hope this is the key, because as I say, I don't know that I've ever done this live. We're going to chance it today. And Dawn has a CD out too. If you actually, you know what, get in touch with me for it, because I got about 4,000 of them downstairs in the basement. A slight exaggeration. I do have a few, and if it's easier to get in touch with me than get in touch with Dawn, get in touch with me, and I'll make sure that you get a copy of it for a reasonable price. I think over there. Let's see what happens. It's a Sunday afternoon. It's Valentine's Day. Lots of love going around. Ah, Jenny, don't go over rolling in the clover. Jenny, don't go over, Jenny, darling. For I find it quite alarming that you find this man so charming as to follow him down over in the clover. Now that's the chorus if you want to sing along in any of these songs. Ah, you know he's courted many, but he hasn't buried any. He's an address like a gypsy, if the truth be known. Wouldn't you rather be a sister on your knees until they blister than to take up with that mister of the roving kind? Jenny, don't go over rolling in the clover. Jenny, don't go over, Jenny, darling. For I find it quite alarming that you find this man so charming as to follow him down over. He's far from being a scholar, he can scarcely earn a dollar. Don't bring him to our father if his health you mind. Wouldn't you rather live life lonely with a fella fat and homely than take up with one who got one thing on his mind? Jenny, don't go over rolling in the clover. Jenny, don't go over, Jenny, darling. For I find it quite alarming that you find this man so charming as to follow him down over in the clover. Well, he's known to be quite frisky, sure one night he tried to kiss me, but with all the drink he missed me, but he got my man. Then one left with another, 9 months later we've a brother, and I'll only say he's nothing like me, poor old pal. Ah, Jenny, don't go over rolling in the clover. Jenny, don't go over, Jenny, darling. For I find it quite alarming that you find this man so charming as to follow him down over in the clover. Now that our brother's age and he would like to be engaging with the pretty girls arranging round him all the time, but he spends his life frustrated, the poor child's barely dated, out of the fear he'd be related to the one he finds. Jenny, don't go over rolling in the clover. Jenny, don't go over, Jenny, darling. For I find it quite alarming that you find this man so charming as to follow him down over in the clover. Jenny, don't go over rolling in the clover. Jenny, for I find it quite alarming that you find this man so played the quite alarming, that you find the stance of charming as they follow him down over in the clover.
Woo!
Ah, well, there it is. It's funny, we were talking about this the other day, myself and Darcy Broderick and Larry Foley were chatting about this, about fast songs and slow songs. And we all love both, but a lot of us prefer the ballads. And we had a big chat about how some of our most favorite singers hated the fast songs. Liam didn't like fast songs at all. And Tommy used to write verses that had a million words in them just to get them to Liam. It was too funny, actually. But anyway, this one, our friend Cyril Sampson, we had a request for Cyril. We had a request for the Galway Shawl, which I'll be glad to do. Cyril has passed on, and Cyril was great fun altogether. He used to show up wherever myself and Brian used to play, be it O'Carroll's at the Triangle or anywhere in Halifax, and the odd time in Cape Breton. And Cyril was a great singer. So Cyril sang Danny Boy like nobody else. And he used to sing this song as well, and we had a lovely request for this song for Cyril, so I will do it, the Galway Shawl. The bartender's over there now. You can take your partners for an old time waltz now. In the county Galway, one pleasant evening in the month of May, I spied a damsel. She was young and handsome, her beauty fairly took my powder, no costly diamond, no, none at all. She wore a bonnet with a ribbon on it, and around her shoulder was a Galway shawl. Oh, we kept on a walking. She kept on talking till her father's cottage, it came into view. She said, come in, sir, and meet me, father, and please to tell to him the foggy dew. She sat me down beside the fire. I could see her father. Oh, he was 6 foot tall. And soon her mother, who was also very tall, had the kettle singing. But all I could think of was the Galway shawl. She wore no diamonds, no paint nor powder, no, none at all. She wore a bonnet with a ribbon on it, and around her shoulder was a Galway shawl. Well, I played the blackbird and the Stacabarty, Rodney's glory, and by God the foggy dew. She sang each note like an Irish linnet, while the tears flowed from her eyes of blue. Try with me. She wore no jewels, Jolene. No costly diamonds, no paint nor powder, no bungalow. She wore a bonnet, oh, she had a tricolor on it, and around her shoulder was a Galway shawl. It was early, early, all in the morning, I hit the road for old Donegal. She said goodbye, sir, I hugged and I kissed her, met me heart and names with the Galway shawl. Samson.
Yay.
And there you are now.
Kevin, just wanted to remind everybody about they can e-transfer PayPal and the gathering place.
Okay, I've just been reminded to let you know. Anyway, because of the situation we're all in at the moment, you can e-transfer something to me, not a problem. And a special thanks for the people who e-transferred
before
the concert. That was very, very lovely of you. The e-transfer is Kevin Barry Evans at Mac, as in the computer, kevinbarryevans@mac.com. You can also do it on PayPal, and it's paypal.me/KevinBarryEvans. And our charity, as always, is The Gathering Place. So feel free to, you know, it's not just going to buy me liquor, like, you know, hopefully buy them. Oh, we won't buy them any. We're going to get them boots and coats. Whoops. I'm going to do a song here for Mr. Paul Bump now and a bunch of you. Johnny just died there. There's no way to edit it because it's live. Oh, well. There's probably not worse things. I'm moving over into Dead Gad territory now. So Mr. Paul requested this song. A bunch of people did, actually. I've been asked before about the guitars. That guitar I was just playing is a Martin D28. It's a dutied up one. It's actually called a Veteran. And it, you probably notice it has all kinds of inlays and stuff. It's very, it's an honor thing, you know. It honors our veterans anyway, and it was done that way. All North American veterans. And it has all the symbols of all the forces and the veterans on it. It's a beautiful guitar. This guitar here is a Northwood, made by John McCory out in BC, and John's wife's family are from Newfoundland, and we've been threatening now for 2 or 3 years that he's going to come here, or I'm going to go there, and obviously in the last year and a half, that ain't working out very well, and it's an absolutely marvelous guitar. It's probably the first guitar that, in fact, it is the first guitar. I promised myself a fancy guitar that I requested to be built to my specs, which my specs are pretty simple. You know, I wanted great wood and great sound, and John did all of that and much, much more. People ask about the guitar, so I figured I'd just talk about them a little bit. It's My favorite combination is mahogany and spruce. The D28 is rosewood and spruce. This has all kinds of little things on it, but this sounds brilliant. And the other thing about this is that I do a lot of different tunings. I'll be doing a couple today. And this guitar was absolutely built for tunings. When John and I first discussed it, I explained that probably 60-70% of the time this guitar would be in a tuning that's lower than standard tuning. So obviously when he built it, he did all kinds of special things with the neck, and he's the expert. I just play that. Fellas, I'm just a banjo player. But you can hear the difference in the tone. The D28 is just rich and just beautiful and very sonic and musical. This is as well, but it has a, because of the mahogany, it's the brighter, and even though the bottom end is still there, that it just rings. And I can lower this actually down to a C tuning with not a bottom end. With most guitars, that would be an issue. Valentine's Day, and I get to spend it with my wife. This could be the Day of the Dead, and I can spend it with my wife because we're in a bubble again. Here in Newfoundland, we're locked in again. As I said, this is for Paul Bump and everybody else who requested it, and I'd like to send it out to the fellow who wrote this song with me, Steve Wainwright. God love him. God rest him. He's up there somewhere. Send him a prayer. Outside, the rain is softly falling. In the distance, I can hear a foghorn sound. And pull my blanket just a little closer. My mind is on a ship that's outward bound. It's through memory, sailing on a silver sea. The moon and stars above now brightly shine. Fills the sails, it's a lullaby, tells a tale of all the things that I was glad to leave behind. The ocean has always been a part of me. I can feel the salt water running through my veins. Think of all the places where the ship will take me, but the sound of your gentle whispers gives me strength. Voyage through memory, sailing on the silver sea, moon and stars above now brightly shine. Fills the sails is a lullaby that tells a tale of all. Look out my little window, a wall of gray is right before my eyes. I can see a clock where time is slowly ticking. How I wish that I could make my life here fly. Stars above now brightly shine. The wind that fills the sails is a lullaby and tells a tale of all the things that I was glad to leave behind. On a voyage through the memory, sailing on a silver sea, the moon stars above now brightly shine. Fills the sails, it's a lullaby that tells a tale of all the things that I was glad to leave behind. Fills the sails, it's a lullaby that tells a tale of all the things that I was glad to leave. Yes. Oh, well, there you go. And, oh, by the way, you can probably see it there. I mentioned John McCrory's name. It's a Northwood. Northwood. Out in BC.
Brilliant guitar.
So, capo time. Got a number of requests for this one. It's great. A lot of the requests I got are from my own songs, which is always lovely. I did have some requests for songs that, though I've done the odd time, I don't usually do, but I'm going to do some of them today. That's close. This is a tune called Road Not Taken. The preamble of the song, you know, it talks about present day, it talks about kind of things that happened, sort of a memory verse. And then the last verse is kind of, talking about the folks there and my friends in my hometown of Dungarvan in the county Waterford in Ireland. And what are we going
to
say?
I was just going to say, which I completely forgot, going back to another story. My sister-in-law, Christina, her cousin who's married to...
There you go. Okay. Joni's brother, my brother-in-law, is married to Christina, whose cousin is John McCrory's wife.
What a chance. It's small. She literally just wrote now to tell me.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That's just her being smart.
Anyway, sorry about that one.
It's okay. Anyway, the last verse, it's just, it's one of those kind of... A very, very sort of a shout out to the friends back home, and almost like, what would it have been had I never left? It's a tune called Road Not Taken. This was written on the couch when Joni and I lived in a gritless street. Literally, we were waiting for Brian Doherty to show up, and we were all going to the airport. It was in May. For our annual May trip to Ireland, so. I live in a warm and friendly city, happy with my life and what I do. Got a wife, she's gentle and so pretty. But come each month of May, I think of you. Road not taken, line not crossed, I still love you. Ah, but only just. I remember Santa summer evening. Helvick, with those flowers in your hair, sipping cider on the steps at Mooney's, breathing in the music in the air, laughing bravely, dancing by the water, drinking creamy pints at Tig an Cio. Drove a Honda 50 off a seawall. A 15-year-old boy out of control. Road not taken. Line not crossed. I still love you. Every year I meet up with my old love, a memory the time cannot erase. I recall each loving, longing moment, every time I look into your face. I will always be wild and restless. She'll be always what I would have been had I stayed and struggled in my hometown. Like all my friends, how I admire them. Road not taken, line not crossed. I still love you. You sound like a million. You sound like a million people. Million people. Now, anything else to report there, Jolie? Nothing going on?
Lots of people chiming in. Lots of people saying they love this song. They love that song.
Good, 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 good.
They're here from all over. Tag Hoolahan is on here.
Tag.
Vicky Wood is on here. Jeez. Mom and Bell.
Loads of people. Sounds like mostly family. Ooh, that's all right. Right. Seeing as it's Valentine's Day, you know, I'll sing one or two Valentine's Day songs. This is very apropos today because of our lockdown and other situations that we're going in. All the shops are closed, and usually, I sort of do everything the day before. Not always, but in the card department, I usually do, because. I like picking, you know, birthday cards and Christmas cards and Valentine's Day cards at the last minute, just kind of like, a lot of them are gone already, and the ones that are left are usually the ones that are a little off. So that's where I go. And today was such a day. My wife got very clever. What she did was she took some old cards and rewrote them. And there's about 3 pounds of chocolate over on the table. So, little chocolates in the shape of a heart. That's what I woke up to this morning. And old cards, you know, sort of just with new stuff. It brilliant. Anyway.
And I sang to you.
Pardon?
And I sang.
Oh, and Joni sang to me this morning. She woke me up with a Valentine's Day song that she made up. Guess I just forgot again. I've only got my love to send on Valentine's Day. I ain't got a card to sign. Roses have been hard to find. I only hope that you be mine on Valentine's Day. I know that I swore that I wouldn't forget. I wrote it all down. I lost it. There's so much I want to say, but all the words just slip away. The way you love me every day is Valentine's Day. And if I could, I would deliver to you diamonds and gold. It's the least I can do. So if you'll take my IOU, I could make it up to you. Until then, I hope my heart will do on Valentine's Day. Until then, I hope my heart will do on Valentine's Day.
Aww, beautiful.
Well, maybe that'll work. From the sublime, as they say, to the ridiculous. Another request, again, a song. Ran into this guy, knew of this fella. His name is Les Barker. He's an English fella, an amazing, amazing poet, actually. Some people call him a folk poet, but he writes song or writes poems about just about anything, and always with a slight edge and a slight twist, you know. And Les wrote this poem, and it's all about a polar bear and an iceberg. And we ran into Les, we were in Albuquerque, New Mexico, doing the Folk Alliance down there, and we ran into Les. It was myself and Brian Doherty, Susan Casey, if you're watching, hello Susan, how are you? Susan, amongst other things, runs the Calgary Folk Club, where we were supposed to be going. Thank you, COVID, appreciate that. And Les Barker. We had a great night in the lobby of the hotel, the last night of the Folk Alliance, great night. And I said to him, I said, you know, that's a fantastic poem. I said, do you mind if I put music to it? And he said, I don't mind in the least. Now, I'm going to say this, and I've said it before in public, so there was drink involved, so he probably forgot that he said that. And maybe, I don't know, I've never gotten a cease and desist letter on this thing, so I certainly didn't forget he said it, and I wrote this, and it's people love this song. We've done it once or twice, and anyway, there's a whole bunch of Titanic stories we can tell you, but we did a Titanic celebration, the 100th anniversary, and I was on in the second set, about the middle of the second set, and everybody who'd gone on before me was singing. I mean, the songs were, and poems and the stories. I mean, it was so sad. And I was gonna sing, you know, one of the sad songs as well. And I said, you know what, I'm gonna sing this song and see what happens. And half the audience thought it was absolutely sacrilegious. And the other half, after about the first two verses, got the fact that it was tongue-in-cheek. Loved it, except for one guy who came up who was actually still searching for his mother. I thought the search had been called off 100 years ago, but that's just me. He didn't like song at all, but I'm hoping it's in this key. And a cold, yeah. So, premise is, everybody's down at the White Star Line office looking for news of their loved ones, and the polar bear comes in and says, look, you know, I know everybody's sad about this, but listen, do you know where the iceberg is? Because my family was on the iceberg. So, has a great chorus to it. It goes, have you got any news of the iceberg? My family were on it, you see. Have you got any news of the iceberg? They mean the whole world to me. So you feel free to sing it. And that's what happens at the end of the song. On a cold, rainy night, on a Liverpool quayside, in the years before the Great War, well, the world was in shock at the loss of Titanic. So proud had they been days before. Relatives gathered for news of their loved ones and to read through the lists of the dead. When into the throng came a sad-eyed old polar bear, and to the clerk at the counter he said, have you got any news of the iceberg? My family were on it, you see. Have you got any news of the iceberg? They mean the whole world to me. Well, my wife and my children, they were coming from Greenland to be by my side in the zoo. Belinda's my wife, and my youngest called Bernard, and Billy, he's only two. Now I know on the ship there were hundreds of people, and I know that the iceberg's not yours. The polar bear's eyes held the start of his teardrops, and he covered his face with his paws. Have you got any news of the iceberg? My family were on it, you see. Have you got any news of the iceberg? They mean the whole world to me. It's been over a year since I last saw my children. I left home to build my career. I've worked very hard. I'm a star in the circus. But it's all been for nothing, I fear. There's my face on the poster. We're in town this week, and my children were meeting me here. Everyone watched as he struggled to speak, and his paw brushed away one more tear. Have you got any news of the iceberg? My family were on it, you see. Have you got any news of the iceberg? They mean the whole world to me. By now, all the people had gathered beside him. His grief was one they could share. The people around him, in sadness and silence, listened to the sad polar bear. I wanted my children to see me performing, and Belinda, she would have been proud. And at last, lost for words, his tears flowing freely, the question was asked by the crowd. Everybody, have you got any news of the iceberg? My family were on it, you see. Come on, Johnny. Have you got any news of the iceberg? They mean the whole world to me. One last time, come on. Have you got any news of the iceberg? My family were on it, you see. Have you got any news of the iceberg? Very sad. That's really sad. Well, it is. It's really sad. I'm sorry. I hope you were singing. Right. We have another request here. This is for the One-Legged Julie. That's a long story. Our friend Julie's had a hard time with her foot and her leg lately, and it's gone from bad to worse to worse to worse to worse to worse to bad to worse to worse to bad. And at the moment, I think it's
improving.
There's the word we're looking for. It's improving. So, but she's still the One-Legged Julie. And she requested this song, and we're glad they're going to do it. A couple of people requested this. It's a tune called The Navajo Rug. And this is a, this would be Tom Russell's song, I believe. Today has a great chorus to it. Again, this, we're getting into the choruses now, right? It goes, I, Katie, shades of red and blue, I, Katie, whatever became of the Navajo rug and you. I first heard the song by Jerry Jeff Walker, and Ian Tyson did a great version of it too. And here's another version. How you doing? just getting the bartender on the go here now. Well, it's two eggs up on whiskey toast and home fries on the side. Wash it down with a roadhouse coffee to choose up your insides. Just a Canyon, Colorado diner and a waitress I did love. Sat in the back, need an old stuffed bear and a worn out Navajo rug. Katie, shades of red and blue. Katie, whatever became of the Navajo rug and you? Try it with me, try it, come on. Katie, shades of red and blue. Katie, whatever became of the Navajo rug and you? Well, old Jack the boss, he left at 6, and Katie, she barred the door. She pulled down that Navajo rug, she spread it on the floor. I saw lightning cross the sacred mountains, I saw woven turtle doves. Lying next to Katie on that worn-out Navajo rug. Katie, shades of red and blue. Katie, whatever became of the Navajo rug? You know, I saw Jack about a year ago. He said, you know, the place burned to the ground. All I say was this old bear tooth, and yeah, Katie, she left town. Ah, but Katie, she got her souvenir too. He said as he spat out a tobacco plug. Yes, should I seen her coming through the smoke, dragging that Navajo rug. Katie, shades of red and blue. Katie, whatever became of the Navajo rug? So every time I cross the sacred mountains and lightning breaks above, it always takes me back in time to my long lost Katie love. But everything keeps a moving, yep, everybody's on the go. You don't find things that last anymore like an old woven Navajo. Katie, shades of red and blue. Katie, whatever became of the Navajo rug? Shades of red and blue, Katie, whatever became of the Navajo rug and you?
Yay!
Yeah, Navajo rug.
Very professional.
Do you think? Yeah. All right.
Very good.
Look, the magic glass.
Tastes like Coke.
I think it's going to taste like Coke, isn't it? Now, a song I don't sing, a beautiful song. We've very lately, myself and Brian have been singing this song. Brian usually sings it, and I'll attempt to sing it today. But we have had a load of requests for it. It's a tune called Grace. And I sang it in G last week with down at Broderick's with Darcy Broderick. Myself and Darcy were playing down there, and it was a wee bit low. So I'm going to try it in A today and hope for the best. And since I sang this song, again, we were in the middle of a shutdown one more time. Everything's closed. So I think the fact that I sang this in G closed down the pub. So I'll just go with that. It's much better. As we gather in the chapel here in old Kilmaine, I think about these last few weeks. Oh, will they say we failed from our school days? They have told us we must yearn for liberty. Yet all I want in this dark place is to have you here. Oh, Grace, just hold me in your arms and let this moment linger. They'll take me out of dawn and I will die. With all my love I place this wedding ring. ring upon your finger, there won't be time to share our love, for we must say goodbye. Now I know it's hard for you, my love, to ever understand the love I bear for these brave men, the love of my dear land. But when Padraig called me to his side down in the GPO, I had to leave my own sick bed. To him I had to go. Oh, grace, just hold me in your arms and let this moment linger. They'll take me out at dawn and I will die with all my love. I'll place this wedding ring upon your finger. There won't be time to share our love, for we must say goodbye. Now as the dawn is breaking, my heart is breaking too. On this May morn, as I walk out, my thoughts will be with you. And I'll write some words upon the wall so everyone will know. I love so much that I could see his blood upon the rose. Oh, grace, just hold me in your arms and let this moment linger. They'll take me out at dawn and I will die. With all my love I'll place this wedding ring upon your finger. There won't be time to share our love, for we must say goodbye. Oh, grace, just hold me in your arms and let this moment linger. They'll take me out at dawn and I will die. With all my love I'll place this wedding ring upon your finger. There won't be time to share our love, for we must say goodbye. There won't be time to share our love, for we must say goodbye.
Grace, that's also for Aunt Beth. Had to do that. Oh, this is one now. This is going to be an interesting one. How are you doing out there? You doing all right?
I'm making them all cry.
I'm what? I'm making them cry. Oh, this is not going to get any better. I have a very, very good friend. We started to know each other musically. And then his name is Rob Curry from the Miramichi. And he lives in, I believe, still lives in Halifax now. Because as far as I know, he's still a legal prof at Dalhousie University. He went on to be a really fancy dancy lawyer. Hopefully I'll never need him, but you know, you never know. But I'm doing a new solo record, and I've decided to do two of his songs on it. Now, I'm going to take a spin on this one. I'm just trying to think if I should. I can't remember what key I did this in. Now, this is going to be a little bit of a. B flat, we're getting to right there. I might try it in there. I'll try it in B. I'm going to throw out a new song to you, seeing as you had a bunch of requests, and Rob actually threw in a request, and his request read something to the effect of, "Well, you know what I want to hear." So I'm hoping that it's one of the two songs that I'm recording by him. But this is a lovely song that he wrote. And luckily, no one's recorded it yet except me, so nobody can quite steal it yet. And if they do, I'll come after you. And he's a lawyer. He'll come after you with me. How's it? I should ask. I'm going to ask over here. How's that? I can see comments coming up there, you know. And I see a comment there. Who's that from? Eileen Burke. His glass needs filling. No, so far so good. So far so good. But the issue right now is that I think... there was only a minute bit of rum, so I think I might have to finish this one and then go for the whiskey. Is everybody doing all right out there? Nothing's moving on here. Is it moving on yours there, Johnny?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, it's fine. Everybody's happy so far?
Yeah, happier.
I haven't alienated anybody yet. That's good. So you'll have to bear with me on this one because this is brand new and... this is called The Rose of Avalon, and I dedicate this to my lovely wife over there, Missy, because she is the Rose of Avalon. So I'll do a, I've already, as I say, I've been in the studio recording this, so it has quite a mystical sort of an intro on it, but we'll do it straight here tonight, just to, so Rob, if you're watching, purposely putting that B out of tune for you, buddy. As I walked out in first daylight through the streets of old St. John's, 'twas there I met a wondrous sight, the Rose of Avalon. 'Twas her dark eyes first that captured me, a gentle light in them shone. I stood transfixed, as fair as this was the Rose of Avalon. A precious pearl is the mainland girl, with beauty like the dawn. I'll make my stand in Newfoundland with the Rose of Avalon. I'll build for her a little house and a chair to rest upon, and by the sea she'll live with me, the Rose of Avalon. A precious pearl is the mainland girl, with beauty like the dawn. But I'll make my stand in Newfoundland with the Rose of Avalon. I must go again to know this lonely road I'm on. I'll sing my part till it reach her heart, the Rose of Avalon. No happier a man could be than to have his eyes upon the rocky East Atlantic shore and the rose of Avalon. And if she'll stay here by my side, and if my love is strong, she'll be content to be my bride, the rose of Avalon. A precious pearl is the mainland girl, with beauty like the dawn. And I make my stand in Newfoundland with the rose of Avalon. A precious pearl is the mainland girl, she has beauty like the dawn. But in Newfoundland I'll make my stand, if she'll have me, with the rose of Avalon. Sweet rose.
Rob Curry, great songwriter. And there's another one. I'll do that one next week. That's a pretty dandy tune as well. Oh, look what's coming up next now. Oh, heavens. I have a little list here, you see. I'm going to do a John Prine song. I normally do a John Prine song. We lost poor old John last year. And I do have to tell you that I wrote a song on the new CD. Within, you know, a day or two after John passed. And it was right around Easter. So it's the song's all about a dream I had, and it was Prine and myself and the Easter Bunny were sitting around having a party. So, wow. Yep. Me and Prine and the Easter Bunny sitting around on Easter Sunday. Plenty of vodka and ginger ale. It's Prine and me and Peter Cottontail. Anyway, that's to come. Well, I packed my bags and bought myself a ticket for the land of the tall palm tree. Goodbye, Halifax Harbor. Oh, hello, Waikiki. I just stepped down from the airplane when I heard her say, "Wacka wacka nooka licka, wacka wacka nooka licka, would you like a lay? Let's talk dirty in Hawaii, whisper in my ear. Kooka pooka maka wawahini, say the words I long to hear. Lay your coconut on my tiki, what the heck, mooka mooka dear. Let's talk dirty in Hawaiian, say the words I long to hear. Oh, it's a ukulele Honolulu sunset. Listen to the grass skirts sway. Drink a rum from a pineapple out on Honolulu Bay. Steel guitars are playing while she's talking with her hands. Gimme okie dokie, make a wish, I wanna poke, words I understand. Sing with me now. Let's talk dirty in Hawaiian, whisper in my ear. Kooka pooka maka wawahini, say the words I long to hear. Lay your coconut on a tiki, what the heck, a mooka mooka dear. Let's talk dirty in Hawaiian, say the words I long to hear. The sad verse now. Well, I bought a lot of junka with my moolah, and I sent it to the folks back home. I never had a chance to do the hula. Well, I guess I should have known. When you're out walking with a sweet wahine, and you're strolling in the pale moonlight, waka waka.
knocker, what I said, a knocker, rock, a sis, boom, bock, a hope, I said it right, chances are good. Let's talk dirty in Hawaiian, whisper in my ear. Kooka, kooka, waka, wawahini, say the words I long to hear. Lay your coconut on the tiki, what the heck, a mooka, mooka, dear. Let's talk dirty in Hawaiian, say the words I long to hear. Let's talk dirty in Hawaiian, say the words I long to
over there just wondering. All right, we'll do another, though this really isn't a Valentine song, but it is one of everybody's favorite writers, Mr. Ron Hines, wrote this song, and this is a last minute addition. Joni's brother Blaine said that I should do this song today, and he's absolutely right when you hear the words. Ron always thought that this was the best song he ever wrote. And I think it's one of his most brilliant songs. It's a tune called Atlantic Blue. And for those who know, they know that tomorrow is the, I believe it's tomorrow, isn't it? Tomorrow's the anniversary of the Ocean Ranger. And how close to Valentine's Day was that? For those who don't know, look up the Ocean Ranger. It was an immense tragedy. I remember singing this song one night, and my friend Paul Grant has a lovely session in Lyons' pub in Schlieverue, and I think it was probably the first time I ever sang this song was there. But it's one of those songs that you sometimes struggle to get through. What shade of memory never fades, but lingers to eternity? How dark is the light of day that sleepless eyes of mine survey? Is that you, Atlantic Blue? My heart is as cold. How is one heart chosen to never lie at peace? How many moments remain? Is there not one sweet release? And who's the stranger at my door to haunt my dreams forevermore? Is that you, Atlantic Blue? My heart is as cold as you. I lie awake in the morning as the waves wash on the sand. I hold my heart at bay. I hold the lives of his children in my hands. And whose plea will receive no answer? Whose cry is lost upon the wind?
Who's the voice so familiar? Whispers my name as the night comes in. And whose wish never fails to find my vacant heart on Valentine? Is that you, Atlantic blue? My heart is cold. My heart is as cold. My heart is as cold as you. Atlantic Blue, Ron Hines. Okay. Well, okay, I'm going to recover from that now.
What's next?
What is next is a song, a Garrison Brothers song. A simple song. Pardon? This is a tune called Thinking of You. This is an oldie. This was the title of the second Garrison Brothers recording. And the claim to fame for this song is that it ended up in the top, in Canada, the top five country songs for the year. And we always laugh because it came in at number four. And Willie came in at number five. So we always thought that was pretty cool. Not so much for Willie. Some of you out there don't know, you're about to tell me something. Some of you out there don't know, but it was one of Tommy Makem's, the great Tommy Makem's, a thing on his bucket list, and unfortunately it never happened, but he wanted to sing a duet with Willie Nelson. So, Joni, you're about to tell me something.
Are you coming to the end of your show?
How many are left do you have? What number is Thinking of You?
Thinking of You is like 14.
Ah, yeah, two or three more, is that right?
Yeah.
Is that okay?
So just bend your mind.
I will do. I'll do this song first. It's called Thinking of You. Standing in the moonlight, 'cause I can't stand the city lights. I wanna walk by myself when I'm thinking of you. Walking down the country lane, listening to the falling rain. There's a hurt inside of me when I'm thinking of you. When I'm thinking of you, sweet baby, you know it gets me down. And when I'm drinking, your memory comes around. So I walk the highways, I'm trying to make my ways. But you know I still got my pride when I'm thinking of you. Garrison Brother endings right there, I gotta say.
Peggy Wood said it's the greatest memories, best Sunday she's spent in forever.
Oh, that's great. That's deadly. Okay. I have to do a little tuning thing here. We're gonna do for Huena.
I haven't done this one in a while either, so you'll have to forgive me if it goes all over the map. But this is a tune called Shine On Brighter. And I have to go back to my trusty Northwood for this, because it's the only one that can hold all these tunings. This is in a strange little tuning. I hope I remember this one now. Oh, there's me. I'm gonna come. I'm running right into you now. There I am. Hello, how's it going? I have to get my tuner. This is a tune called Shine On Brighter, another one of those. It's sort of, it's not really a Dungarvan trilogy, but it's pretty close. And I gotta go. This could change now, we'll break a string. So this is. It's an open G tuning right now. Which is. Actually, open G was. I played a lot of open G in the Garrison Brothers, New Folk Trio. And it was when I started playing with Brian that I kind of transferred over to Dead Gad a lot, because of the bottom. Brian played guitar quite a bit, so I always wanted that bottom low D. So that's open. That's open G, but this tuning here is, and that's why it's taking a little long, but this tuning here is almost like an old sawtooth tuning. That bum bum bum, it goes up to a C, excuse me. Almost there. So this is an old that little inversion there is kind of an old banjo. This is a tune called Shine On Brighter. Again, as I mentioned, it's kind of one of the. I haven't done this in donkeys either, so you'll forgive me if it goes, as they say in Dungarvan, scaways. A nod to my guitar teacher and best friend, God rest him. He's, as I mentioned earlier, he's not with us anymore. Paddy Daly is mentioned in this song, as is my mother. And it's that's a true verse. My mother used to, my mother, when I was in the States and she was still living in Ireland, she never figured out the time zones. And you would get, you know, you'd get those calls in the middle of the night, you'd be thinking, oh my God, what's wrong? You know, the emergencies and all this. Nah, it's just my mother not figuring out the time zones. You call me at 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock in the morning from Ireland. See how this goes. Are you all right out there? You doing okay?
We're all doing great.
Oh yeah, all right. As long as you're. This for Eoin and Enid. Best chocolate chip cookies in the world, gotta say. But I shouldn't say, because there are three or four more people that make them. But they're the best chocolate chip cookies attached to this song. So I hope I get through that. I haven't done this in donkeys, have I? Years ago when I was young, I sat out in the Irish sun, stretched upon the riverbank. I thought about which road to take. The mysteries of America called me stronger every day. So I left my home behind to see what in the world I'd find out there. Where I could shine on brighter, hold on tighter, keep it lighter than any love I'd known. Keep me dreaming
never leaving, always feeling like I'd never have to go. I landed fresh upon the shore with bulging eyes and not much more. Friendly people took me in, and so began my wandering. I tried the cities to the south, tried mountain high and river bound. Golden beaches, snowy plains, just pack my bags and go again. To where it would shine on bright, hold on tighter, keep it lighter than any love I'd known. Keep me dreaming, never leaving, always feeling like I'd never have to go. Seven years just flew on by without a glimpse of home. Too busy singing songs about the ramble and the roam. Then late one night it hit me, the only things that got me right were Patty Daly's letters and my mama's phone calls at night. Oh, she'd always call me so damn late at night, but they'd help me to shine on brighter, hold on tighter, keep it lighter than any love I'd known. Keep me dreaming, never leaving, always feeling like I'd never have to go. Now I am an older man, getting on in years, got wrinkles round these curious eyes, white hair in my beard. I sat upon a riverbank and came to realize everything I'd searched for was right before my eyes. At home, at home, where I can shine on brighter, hold on tighter, keep it lighter than any love I'd known. Keep me dreaming, never leaving, always feeling like shine on brighter, hold on tighter, keep it lighter than any love I know. Keep me dreaming, never leaving, always feeling like I'd never have to.
Switching back over one more time. I think we're getting close to the end here now. How am I doing there, Joni? Am I doing all right?
You're doing fantastic.
Fantastic.
Any better?
Right. Another new song. This is another new song off the record. Now, I sang one of Dawn's songs earlier. Now, I don't know this song, so this should be fun. But I figured I'd throw it out to you because it has a great chorus. The chorus is, "It's a dog's life without question and not for the faint of heart." Now, it has audience participation. I'm going to show you where it is. "Not for the faint of heart." And then I sing, "But we suffer," and "Raise your glasses." And we do it for the art. "Forced to roam," though. Excuse me. What'd you put in that drink?
Can't be telling you.
"Forced to roam the whole world over with our music and our song. If you're with us, raise your glasses. And for Ireland, sing along." So all you got to know is "raise your glasses." And it comes after, "But we suffer, raise your glasses." And then at the end, "If you're with us, raise your glasses." So I did you hear somebody out there singing?
No.
I did. They were singing "Raise Your Glasses." They're out there.
So, is this your last song or is it kind of your last song?
This is my last song. Yeah, I'm going
to
do this.
You should say goodbye to your...
Oh, yeah. Well, I'm...
All that stuff,
I'm being directorialized. I like it.
I'm not being
presentable. It's been a pleasure spending time with you. And it's not over. I'm presuming this thing is going to be up for a while.
I think it's up for 24 hours.
Okay, it's up for 24 hours. So, again, not to belabor the point, but... If you care to donate, it is for an e-transfer. It's my email address, which is kevinbarryevans@mac.com, and the PayPal for all those who aren't in Canada or Catholic is paypal.me/kevinbarryevans. And I know that's how Mr. Paul Bump sent something in. And as always, our charity is the Gathering Place. So we hope to raise loads. So don't, you can watch this again. You can donate away anytime you donate anytime you want. KevinBarryEvans@mac.com, and we'll see that it gets to all the places it has to get to. We're in a very strange, we're going back to complete lockdown here. And just to let everybody know, from the Evans and Doherty point of view, Brian and I actually managed to record an hour last September, which sometime in March, before St. Patrick's, we're going to get it on the website or maybe even here on Facebook or whatever. And it's an hour concert. Essentially, it's the new form of the DVD, I suppose. You download it like you would a CD, and we'll have it up there. But it's an hour of us just singing songs and fooling around like two old friends do. Is that good? Did I say everything?
Yeah, you've covered everything.
I hope I've covered everything. Now, in regards to the requests that you've sent in that I didn't get to today, I'm hoping, if this time works out for everybody, it's certainly working out for us, if this is a good time for everybody, Sunday afternoon, have a little laugh, you can watch it later, as Joni said, we'll do another one next Sunday, right? And what I'll do is I'll go, keep sending in your requests. And I'll make a list as we go along. And I mean, there's some great requests I just couldn't get to today because we'd be here all night, and nothing wrong with that. But if I'm going to be here all night, I want a drink. So Don Trainor Thompson wrote this song. It's a brand new song. Raise your glasses. Round of applause out there for the wonderful Joni, who's been over there just making sure I don't go too far off the rails, which is great. Thanks very much for being here. Support every musician you can, including ourselves, God help us. This is turning into year two now with, it's just crazy. Brian and myself were talking the other day. We had we booked it with the theaters. We had a full March tour booked again this year, which we've now moved to 2022. So this year looks like it's pretty much going to be shot as well. So, fine, pardon? Yes. Stay safe, download the COVID app. Mine hasn't gone off yet, so that's pretty good. And it seems to be working. So take care of yourselves. Now I have to see if this is in the right key. I've come back this could be iffy. But why not? Why not make the iffy one the last song? I don't see anyway. Raise your glasses, now remember. Maybe I'll sing the chorus. It's a dog's life without question, and not for the faint of heart, but we suffer, raise our glasses, and we do it for the art. Forced to roam the whole world over with their music and our song. If you're with us, raise your glasses, and for Ireland sing along. Maybe I'll do it up one. I'll do it in C. For those of you who are accounting, Pat Chesel. So we'll do the chorus one more time. It's a dog's life without question, enough for the faint of heart, but we suffer, raise your glasses, and we do it for the art. Forced to roam the whole world over with our music and our song. If you're with us, raise your glasses, and for Ireland sing along. There it is. I've come under speculation for this line of work I'm in, moving all around the country, drinking whiskey, rum and gin. Making eyes at all the ladies, keeping hours way too long, waking up in time for supper, going to bed just before dawn. It's a dog's life without question, and not for the faint of heart. But we suffer razor glasses, and we do it for the art. Forced to roam the whole world over with our music and our song. If you're with us, raise your glasses, and for Ireland, sing along. We believe it is our duty, and it's not for holding in. Stand up tall and raise your voices if you have a song to sing. We have songs of all description, but it's when we hear the crowd with their voices all united, we know Ireland would be proud. It's a dog's life without question, not for the faint of heart, but we suffer, raise your glasses, and we do it for the art. Forced to roam the whole world over with our music and your song. If you're with us, raise your glasses, and for Ireland, sing along. There are scientific minds that hold scholastical degrees, more to use their intellect to cure us of disease. Some from high social standing, princes, noblemen, and king, born as leaders of their nation, but us boys were born to sing. It's a dog's life without question, and not for the faint of heart, but we suffer, raise your glasses, and we do it for the art. Forced to roam the whole world over with our music and our song. If you're with us, raise your glasses, for Ireland, sing along. It's a dog's life without question, not for the faint of heart, but we suffer, raise your glasses, and we do it for the art. Forced to roam the whole world over with our music and your song. If you're with us, raise your glasses, and for Ireland, sing along. If you're with us, raise your glasses, and for Ireland, sing along. Good evening. Thanks very much. See you again soon. Oh, next Sunday. All right. Take care. Now I got to stand up and push that off, don't I?
You sure you do.
Woo! Okay. This is, wait a minute now. This is, how do I do it? This is getting down and personal. See you later.